今押しました。
それではですね、サハ先生は、日本語が結構ありますので、ある程度イントロダクションのことをですね、英語でも日本語でもどっちでもいいんですけども、まあジャパングリッシュです。基本日本語で言って、途中面倒くさくなったら英語に切り替えて、英語でさせていただきたいと思います。今日は、IIT デリカですね、協定校の、本研究家のですね、本学の、インスティショナルレベルの、協定校である IIT、インド工科大学のデニー校から、プロフェッ レスラーの佐賀先生に来ていただきました。というよりも、実はここにいらっしゃる、松永大学の IPS の松丸先生です、松丸教授がいらっしゃっていただいています。こちらの方に受け入れて訪問していらっしゃったので、ぜひ一緒にお立ち寄りくださいということで、今日発表をしていただくことになっております。で、グローバル AR コースというのが、まあ、10月からですね、立ち上がりますけれども、まあ、その、ぜひ、先生のところからも、私の柴田県にもですね、学生が一人に集中していただきますが、まあ、今後のこともあるので、ぜひお世話になりたいということで、客員教授にですね、これから推薦の予定です。いただけると思います。簡単に、もう非常に先生もいっぱいイントロダクション用意されているので、ごく簡単にイントロダクションさせていただきますと、IIT カラグプールで MTEC を取られた。こっちでいうマスターコースのことは、ここで MTEC と言いますね。BTEC、MTEC、ね。あとはドクターで、ドクターコースですね。で、マッカナダのマクギルユニバーシティでドクターを取られた。で、そこからドクターを取られた後に東芝に行かれたので、日本語は結構上手です。今のところ結構、ね、リスニングの方も結構大丈夫です。だから質問がですね、日本語でしかできない人はどうぞしていいと思います。そして現在も非常に大活躍されているので、IIT デリでも2010年からナレン・グプタ・チェア、プロフェッサー氏、もうチェアという非常に偉い人のことを言うんですけれども、そのチェアになられていると。では、今日もご紹介になりますが、本もいろいろ書いておられる。ご専門はマルチボディダイナミクスということですね。そして、ご本人の2つの特別なインタレストとしては、イノベーティブリサーチとだけでなくてですね、イノベーティブティーチングメソドロジー、教育というのも大変興味深いと思います。
ありがとうございます。
あとは英語ですので
。もちろん、どう
ぞ。グラフトゥーン、エブリバディ。こんにちは。電気どうする？アンテナの前の。
経験しますけど。
The title of my presentation is a little unconventional, robotics to rural R square. So my PhD and my Toshiba research experience was on robotics. Then slowly after 10 years of my work experience at IIT Delhi.In fact, I must do something for the rural also. And I call it an inclusive education in engineering. The reason will be very clear later on. So this is the introduction. Maybe I'm blocking your way, so I come here, or what should I do?So this is the same introduction as Professor Shibata has given to you. So BTEC, IT3, MTEC, IT5, IIT Kharagpur, and Toshiba. And then I went back to Madras. And then, I'm sorry, no, I'm just thinking I should not block anybody's view. So I will turn it.So then, I was in Stuttgart for about a year as a board fellow, and then for short visits here and there to keep me alive, because after hard work at IIT, I need some breaks. So this is one of the breaks. For almost like 4 weeks, I'm traveling to various places. Okay, so here I am.From IIT Delhi, which is north of India, and I came to your place in the Kyushu Institute. Since Professor Shibata is from computer science department, and I presume most of you probably would be from computer science or electrical or similar, so I thought of removing most of my mechanicalequations from here. Rather, let's talk about a little bit of philosophical. So I call it techno-philosophical talk. So don't expect too much of technology here, But why from robotics to rural? I wanted to give some feeling because worldwide also there is a change is happening and I wanted to be part of it. So first, of course, I will present my robotics activities in PAR lab or Brahmapur Autonomous Robotics. It's a sponsored laboratory and then the mechatronics laboratory. Then I have two philosophical questions here. What is education? Who is a teacher? Right? Based on which the later part of my research work is associated with the answers which I want to share with you. And the answers are basically here, two concepts, Rugby and the Mudra. Let me explain later as I go along. Finally, the conclusion. But I wanted to introduce the IIT systems in India. IITs are the centers of excellence and it's globally well known. Originally, we had about seven, starting from 1951 and to 2005, we had seven. Then suddenly there is a huge growth. The government decided to create nine around 2008 and 9. And only last year, they said, okay, let's add few more. So with this new addition, maybe another 2 or 3 years, will be 23 centers. Talking about Japan's relationship, you know, 2008, the Hyderabad place, it is in collaboration with Japan. And I know Professor Shibata is going very regularly to Jodhpur, I think it's somewhere here, coming Jodhpur, okay? Maybe here, here. About IIT Delhi, it is more than 50 years old. It's one of the smallest campuses amongst all IITs, 320 acres, 13 departments, 11 centers. Schools are the sponsors. Different companies sponsor technical education. So there are three schools, and we have about 8,000 UG and PG students. This is the campus scenery. This is our one of our main building, we call it. All the science departments and administrative offices are here. Then this is the green. Many of you may be familiar with this auto rickshaws. In Thailand, they call it tuk-tuk, no? So we call it auto rickshaws. A very cheap, convenient way of traveling around. This is our library, central library, Toshokan. So this is the symbol of IIT Delhi in many of our publications. Come to our laboratory, the PAR, it is a program for autonomous robotics, sponsored by Bhabha Atomic Research Center in west of India, Mumbai. PAR is a government organization, and our website is here, robotics.iitd.ac.in. And I will take you for a virtual tour here. The first one is mostly for those who would like to come to IIT and to have a feel that how robotics laboratory looks like and how the students work as the ambience. So this is kind of an ambience. So the area we have it, we just enter in our lab. This talks about our activities. About 12 plus faculty members, 3 departments, computer science, electrical, mechanical, 20 plus students, and our work has been divided into 5 sub-projects. And I will show you the videos of those for about 30 seconds or 45 seconds each. So this guy is wearing an exoskeleton device which we have developed. Now we are entering a small lathe machine and drilling machine in front of the lab, and then as you enter the lab, name and some instructions students must follow before leaving the room. So I'll go a little fast here, otherwise a little boring. This is one of the latest robot we bought it, Kuka LWR, lightweight robot. This is the exoskeleton we built at IIT Delhi for teleoperation purposes. There will be a video of the teleoperation as well. first year again. So some of our publications by the students, this is a lab, little crowded though. The immersive, I think computer science people will understand quite well. Sometimes it's a little confusing, but I'll explain you what it is. So this is the real robot, the Kumar KR5 Art, an industrial robot. It's a German robot. And this is a close view of the gripper where the manipulation will happen. Remotely, when you control this, if you depend only on the vision, you will not be able to control it properly to pick up this object. So what we did is we have created a virtual environment and the virtual manipulation of objects. So it's a computer science graphics. Students and professors jointly developed this thing. And an operator can see this and can control this. Okay? So that's the idea here. Because if you create a stereo vision here also, there will be time delay. And you will not be able to control from the remote distances. So here, what you see is the operator's view. And this is the real video that's coming. And this line is indicating the center of the small space of about 12 to 15 millimeter diameter. So it picked up, as you see here. And these lines are indicating the distance, okay, the norms of these vectors, basically. And now you will place on the top of another thing here. And the operator can change the view by a click of a button, the button has been created. And now he can quite accurately place one peg on the top of another peg. The video continues for another 10-30 seconds to place another peg on the top of it, but I will stop here and take you to the next video. The next one is the another project on mobile robot. It's a project in our electrical engineering group. So the three mobile robots, the idea is to control it, say in a circle, the centroid of these three mobile robots will follow a circle, predefined path for center of formation. So they are forming a shape. And these kinds of activities are required when you want to explore. Suppose Fukushima a disaster, you want to see whether radiation is happening or not. You may send several robots, but simple robots certainly will not work there. But imagining the area can be accessed by mobile robot, then you can do this kind of formation control to find out what is the radiation level or some disaster, something is happening. So that's the second one. And what I will show next is two projects combined together. So there is a vision. Vision has seen this face and identified one face to be picked up. And then that peg will be inserted in a tube here. That's a pneumatic. So you are getting the sound of the air pressure. So now another gripper will come and hold it from the top. We are doing it a little slow for safety reason. I can make it a little fast by dragging it. The interesting thing here is now is this camera is watching this hole, so it will approach, but the clearance of this peg and the hole is only 0.1 millimeter diameter. So after some time, it will not be able to insert properly. So we switch over to force control. So feeling the force around the edges, we can find out what is the location of the center, and then I can insert it. So this is for the particle. Insertion is not an issue. Once you find out the volume, just releasing it will go inside. But in actual scenario, we need a horizontal push. So it will repeat same thing. Let's see whether it is somewhere in the horizontal one or not. Let's see whether it picks up the horizontal one. Once it takes the picture, it can take 2-3 such pellets before it confuses. Then it has to take another picture. I think now it is taking another picture here before it approaches. Now it is coming. What it picks up, and those algorithms have been developed in our electrical engineering department. And the one which will be picked up is the nearest from the end effector. It's coming. I think it will take one of the horizontal ones. And now it will place it in a vertical mode because the next one will be okay. And the next step is the same as the previous step. So I can stop here. Then the horizontal one will be done in a similar manner. So the previous part we are not showing it, we are showing directly picking up and then the force. Portions here, and the algorithm here is actually when I rotate in a conical shape like this thing, I can know that when the hole is there, it will dip little more. For example, if this is my peg and this is my hole, so I go at some position here and touch, I get a force feeling, I have a threshold value, and then I do like this. So here, more dipping is happening, right? And once I do this thing, wherever the depth is more, so I know the center lies along that direction. So that's the depth-based algorithm to find out the center. Once it is inserted a little bit, then this gripper portions comes and obstructs it. So it needs to be pushed. So we have two pushes. Here we physically push by the finger. Alternatively, you can have a pneumatic air supply through these cables. And it can push it directly, but what I'm showing it is the mechanical push here. So here we have used the force torque information. Okay, so the last one of the part lab is teleoperation of an industrial robot. This is purely indigenous developer. My colleague, Mr. Shudipta Mukherjee, is very fond of building things. I like modeling, he likes building. So here he built this thing from the scratch, and this will have a haptics feedback also. Here we are not showing the insertion of the pellet in the hole, but the demonstration that I can pick up a pellet and place it in some bigger hole. So this is a little big hole. This boy will place it here. He is a student of master's. And Professor Mukherjee. So you just, it's pretty big actually. Okay. So these are the five projects under the sponsored laboratory. Then we go to the little old laboratory. The other one started 2010, this one 2001. So here, first I'll show you what is called a parallel room. Most of the industrial robot, as you've seen, Kuka, is a serial type, like our hands. But we have parallel robots here, which are used as simulators. Flight simulators, you have seen probably some places in amusement parks. Here we would be used as a truck simulator, a truck simulator. So So after we manufactured it, this is the video of initial testing. A simple heave, sway, roll motion. It has six legs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 legs. And you can rotate it, you can move it. One of the challenges with this kind of robot is singularity. Well, serial robot has also singularity. But parallel robots have a different type of singularity also, which we call is a gain singularity. So if you do not understand what is a gain singularity, today I will show you a demonstration of a gain singularity. And it is a work of a master's student who just finished his degree. Well, you got an idea how the parallel manipulator works. Before, of course, we designed it, we have to do the analysis. I'm a multibody dynamics modeler, but for validation of our results, we use the commercial software. So this is Ricardine, the Korean software. Professor Choi is the owner. He has a business now, actually. He's a teacher and he's both. Okay, so that was for the dynamic analysis. We verified the results by importing the CAD data into our Ricardine software. The singularity is here. So this is a student, Sashank Sina, just finished it. I'll take you to the singularity portion. So he's going to explain all mathematics, which I skip. Watch this robot. This is a smaller model we also built in Rotterdam. The other one is for the our organization follow. That is a 1 ton capacity. This is only about 500 gram capacity. See, after some time, what happened? Oops, right? So again, it will come. Suddenly falls. Yes. So that's actually singularity. No? At that singularity, the robot has gained extra degrees of freedom. What it is? Let's see the another video here. You see? You can move it. No? You can play. So that means all the encoded readings which comes, it will not give you the true position and orientation. So in real life, you must know that there is a singularity there. Either you should avoid it while moving your trajectory, or you should do something so that you can cross the singularity. Okay? So that cross portion I will not discuss in today's lecture. I just wanted to tell you that one has to be very careful about that analysis part. Okay? So I stop this one. Yet, we have 90 minutes. I decided to spend about 75 to 80 minutes. So, yeah. Okay, so other than the research, now I have a lot of interest with the students. So, this is the student robotics, you may call it. Just watch. So, many of you may be aware of Robocon. How many of you know about Robocon? Can you please raise? Okay. That is 2, 3, I can see. So this is the Indian competition of Robocon this year. The theme is playing badminton, because the international game will be held in August in Indonesia. So they have given this theme. So this is the IT Gallery's robot. Most of the robots could serve, but could not receive, because that's a little challenging. So this is a robot, this is opponent. So they could not receive it. So my idea is if the students can make their own robots, okay, they will gain the skill of integrating mechanical, electrical, basically the mechatronics. Okay, at very early, because this game is for the undergraduate students only. So now the opponent has tried. So the next. So our team could not succeed in the top position, but they got an award, the best design award. Okay. Okay, I will come back to this topic later on. Please remember this video that badminton played over. Okay. Well, that's about the research activities which I've been doing it for last almost 20 years, right? But after 10 years of my work, I started in 1996, around 2005, I had these questions actually. What is education? Because I was following my predecessors. And when you say predecessors, our predecessors mostly follow West. Okay? Because, you know, whatever may be the reason, economic reason may be. Right? So because our employment mostly can be better if the big businesses come to India, right? So if America says, you know, this is the research you should do, say medical research, they need a lot of manpower. So if we want to do those kind of research, we need money. So then the money comes, okay? So mostly influenced by they call developed nations, okay? So, but what is the education and who is the teacher? Am I following, even if it's guided by the developed nation, but is it true fulfillment of education and teaching? Well, let us go back actually. Okay, let's look at some philosophers. Well, start from home. Anything you do, you should start from home, right? So I started from home. Swami Vivekananda, who is an Indian philosopher, during very short life he lived actually, 39 years only. He writes, is education is a book learning? Of course, his answer is no. Is it a diverse knowledge? Not even so. Okay. So what is education? According to him, education is not filling the mind with a lot of facts. In fact, in our schools, this is the things can happen. Okay, that you just memorize facts. Then the next point, the education which does not help common mass of people to equip themselves for the struggle for life, which does not bring out strength of character, is it worth? Okay, so that's the question. Okay. Then let's go to Western now. Let's go out and see what Western teachers are telling. There is the English teacher who says, I want my son to struggle and to feel challenged. I want my children, both my own and the children in my class, to fail and to be able to learn from these failures in order to move forward and to gain deeper understanding. The third person says, I think the purpose of education is to teach children how to fail, okay? To drive them to failure and then see what happens. Most of us do not like this, right? We want always success, 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 right? But that's not the education probably, right? Even the Western. Who is a teacher? So first, what is education? So we understand some meaning from some philosophers, some teachers, from both worlds. Who is a teacher? Again, Swami Vivekananda says, the only true teacher is the who can immediately come down to the level of the student and transfer his soul to the student's soul and see through the student's eyes and hear through his ears and understand through his mind. So that means if I want to teach you well, I should be you actually. You know, I should be your clone, right? What you are thinking sitting in that desk now, that how Saha is doing his lecture. Is he wasting my time or, you know, or he's trying to tell me something, right? Then only I should be able to feel what I should say. Again, Western concept, William Arthur Ward says, the mediocre teacher tells, the good teacher explains, the superior teacher demonstrates, the great teacher inspires. So now it is my decision now, I want to be in which category, right? I want to be around this. So of course, the green means always nice, green, right? Environment. I want to be this, right? I want to inspire. Well, from the student's perspective, if you look at it, another Western person says, Benjamin Franklin says, tell me and I forget. Teach me and I remember. Involve me and I learn. Right? So now, can I combine the philosophies of both the worlds and see now what should I do for my teaching and research career? Okay? Well, answer to these two questions I found in these two concepts which evolved over the period of time. The first concept is ROCBE, Robotics Computation Knowledge-Based Education in Engineering. It has come to my mind through this concept, Robocon, right? Since 2002, I've been guiding my students for Robocon. What happens when you do this? Fun learning, right? You are not pressurized by your exams. But, of course, competition. If you fail, you are still not failed in terms of your graduations of first year, second year, third year. Well, you feel bad, but you're still not doing it. And competition makes young mind very competitive, actually. They would do their best, right? But if it's an exam tomorrow morning, there's an exam. Somehow if I can get past, it's all right, right? And the joy of creation. Right? Every individual is like this. Right? Now, for example, if you are 15, 16, 17 years old and you see your father or your elder brother is driving a motorcycle at 120 kilometers per hour, now you wait for that day when you will be driving that motorcycle at 120 kilometers. So here is the joy of creation, almost like a mother gives birth to a baby, right? So when you create a robot, you get that kind of feeling. So that was kind of education, how to involve my undergraduate students in that kind of thing. Then coming to research, again going back to, unless it contributes to the society, how come it is a research? So I was involved in some rural projects, one or two demonstrations I do it since 2003, and I call it multi-body dynamics for rural application. And the mudra, the acronym has been chosen in such a manner, mudra also means money, in many Indian languages, okay? And mudra also means postures of different yoga, okay? Now, for your information, 21st June is the Yoga International Day. So please remember, and if International Yoga Day has been declared a few months ago, so International Yoga Day, 140 countries have signed this agreement. International Yoga Day. Okay? And in Delhi, we call it Rajpath, it's a big road where Prime Minister will do the yoga with about 10,000 people. Anyway, so coming back to this, here also joy of creation continues because you are building things for the application in the rural area. But additional thing happens, satisfaction of helping society. Okay? Many of my students told me, sir, after doing this, I feel a great satisfaction because most of my research I have done in the last 20 years, other than this rural, I do not know who is using. Well, Google Scholar gives, so many people have done it, right? ResearchGate does it. But how much it is contributing to the development of a real industrial world, I have no clue. Okay? But here I can see in front of my own eyes, the person is using. Okay? So let's talk about ROCBE first, the robot. So Robocon, of course, they make, they participate, they come back, okay? But after that, what? To me, I have to integrate with that academic activity because they learn, say, design, okay? Are they applying to this robot design? I did not know when they participated. When they come back, I ask them, can you now analyze why your robot has failed? If your robot has not failed, can you develop certain program which will help a young first year student to design a robot very quickly? So here is an example of a small software developed by some students during their final year project. So here I have a small software graphical user interface which actually designs a bottom platform of a mobile robot. I have some default values here, so I just click next and next. So it asks for what is the maximum velocity you want to achieve, what is the slope you want to go. So all dynamics and design is inside, okay? And then you go, and it gives some analysis results. So if these are the parameters you choose, your robot will not topple, otherwise it may topple, okay? And then you say, okay, accept indicated stuff. And it tells you what should be the design of the wheel. So you click design of the wheel, it gives you the shape of the wheel. And what will be the D1, D2, D3 parameters. So you can go to the market and probably purchase those things. So first year students may not need to know what is dynamics inside. So my final year student has done this job for them. Okay? And here is the motor torque required, and so you can order the motor very quickly. So this is a kind of integration has been done with Robocon and the academic studies they do in their daily classes. The second one, after they say B, another set of students have developed some hardware. We give a name RoboMuse. So RoboMuse, our dream is it should be 24 hours running robot in the campus, mainly for the entertainment purposes. Maybe one day it will stay in front of my director's office, welcoming guests like you, right? Welcome to IIT Delhi, you know. Just like you see in some of the supermarkets, demonstration happening in Japan. And I want this to be done by the students. So by the students, for the students, right? So here's a small demonstration, a conversion of a Robocon robot to a project which we call it RoboMuse project. Again, if you look for the meaning of RoboMuse, you can find it out why did we give the name RoboMuse. So here is a task which can be industrially applicable task also. So complete design analysis integration done by a pair of students who got the best hardware project award last year. So this I put it in the YouTube also. You give RoboMuse 3, you give it 6. The challenges are many actually, other than the mechanical. This charging station needs to be very reliable. So here I wanted to introduce the concept of reliability and robustness. Because many of my students, after they make it, they take part in Robocon and then come back and then do not pay attention to these robots. After some time when I tell them to maintain it, they say, sir, our job is done. Right? We do not do it. So after a few months of thinking, I told them, suppose if your parents have given birth to you and then let you go anywhere you like, right, what would have happened? Sir, this is a different story. I said, no, sir, this is not a different story. It's the same story. You have given birth to a robot. If you do not take care of the robot, it will become an orphan, right? It will die. Just like if your parents would have left you on the street, no? You would have died. You won't come to IIT to study. Okay? So anyway, so finally what happens is fun learning continues, as I told. And this year, 2015, there is a developing countries forum was there. One of my students, undergraduate students, presented this concept, ROCB, in the conference. Well, that's about ROCB. So I created a lecture series to tell people, right, this is a nice way to study, actually, to understand engineering. So this is a kind of lectures I'm giving. Well, then I have a small book which we thought, because in many places I cannot travel. So here is a small book. This is a kind of a story form. I heard that one of our Indian movies became very popular in China and Japan also. It's called Three Idiots. I don't know who haven't heard about Three Idiots. So it is almost in a similar theme. Three Idiots is a very popular movie. So inside the story, it is a story of our IIT students, how they intermingle with others, how do they fight, how do they love each other, how do they find a girl, how the girl finds a boy, all those stuff, right? Well, some feedback. I'll take two feedback, one from a student, one from a professor from USA. So here is a student who has started business now. He has office in India and San Francisco. So Click Labs, his company's name. So once I met after a few years, I for one always thought that education was not that important. See this guy, right? He was a computer science student. Computer science means one of the brightest students in IIT, because the top rank card takes generally computer science. But I could not have been more wrong. I still feel their rote learning, this is really important, is not the right way. The training and value that Robotics Club taught me have been most influential in shaping my thinking and approach to robotics. So that was very encouraging to me. So I am not in the wrong direction, so I am in the right direction. Here is the professor whom I gifted this ROBV in 2011. He writes me back, SK Subir Kumar, great to meet you in Guanajuato in Mexico. Your experience with your robotics project is exactly the same experience that I am having with my race car projects. He encourages the race car project. I have just had a meeting with the high school administrators who are surprised and excited to hear that this is possible for their students also. I believe it is the right thing for our engineering students and the right thing for our high school students. It creates a foundation of experience that helps students understand the great science and technology that we have developed in over the years. Okay. So again, it validates the model. Okay. So now goes to the next answer, the mudra, multimodal dynamic. Again, let's look at home. Okay. Mahatma Gandhi, as many of you may know, he was our India's freedom fighter, but he was a great philosopher also. Very contemporary, you see, Swami Vivekananda 1861, 63, and this is 1869, he's younger, but he lived longer though. He says, the purpose of education, want and knowledge must never be separated. Many times we do this mistakes in our life, right? What we learn, maybe mechanical engineering, but as a word, we are doing software engineering, right? What? It is economically driven though. Okay, so you cannot always follow this principle all the time. Sometimes you have to be practical because without money we cannot live. But some of those things are meaningful. To eliminate the rural-urban divide and redress the structural and socio-economic imbalances that were around in Indian society. Not in Indian society, in global. I'll show you a book now. This book has been published in the USA, designed for the other 90%. Any idea what is the meaning of other 90%? If you want to help me to have a guess. Well, think of it later also, but I will give you the answer. Okay? 90% means 90% of the population, the earth, on earth, are below poverty line, poverty level. Can you believe it? Right? Well, in India we have a lot of poor people, right? And if you go to similar countries, you'll see, but 90%. But only, 90% of people living below poverty level, but 90% of the designers and researchers are actually working for the 10% of the rich companies. That's a sharp contrast, okay? Well, it is published in the USA, and I thank Professor Matsumaru here, you know, one of our visits to Japan, in, I think 2012, he introduced the Japanese version to me, and later on I bought the Indian version, English version. So the worldwide, there are programs in many universities, in USA let's talk about, Entrepreneurship Design for Extreme Affordability is a very popular program now at Stanford. Engineering Projects in Community Services, a very strong project in Purdue, 500 undergraduate students take this activity. In Europe, Oxford, Delft, the Netherlands, and in India we also started about 10-15 years ago, RUTA. Which I am looking after now in IIT Delhi, Rural Technology Action Group, a National Innovation Foundation, Indian Institute of Management, a professor, and very recently our Ministry of Human Resource Development has launched what is called the Unnat Bharat Abhiyan, means a journey towards the developed India. Well, to share this kind of concepts, again, I have been pursuing campaigning kind of thing, and even already 46. Well, let me demonstrate what is it. First, see the video and enjoy a little Indian music here. Okay, let me show you what I'm trying to talk about it here. This is related to the carpet. Now, carpet, Indian carpets are very popular. The one which is popular is the hand woven because the hand touches there. That sells actually at very high cost. Right? We Indians many times cannot afford those. It has to be sold in US or Japan. Okay? So this is the way they are living. Forget about child labor part. I'm not going to all the social discussions there, but the social techno-social discussions. Right? So this is a wooden beam, and these are the vertical. These are cotton threads, and horizontally they call it weft. So these are woolen color and the weave. The most challenging part is to these threads have to be kept at very high tension, almost like 2 to 3 tons, pulling a small truck, right? And 2 persons, 20 minutes required. What we provided is this kind of arrangement, a small gearbox. 1 person, 10 minutes, can do the job. So that kind of help, very little input in terms of knowledge is required. But there are challenges, of course, acceptability by those people, because they have not seen this kind of thing. So when you introduce, they think you are kind of intervening their domain of business. You know? Who is this guy, you know, like a Gujarati, for them, right? I mean, you know, from cities to the villages. So that's a different challenge. But anyway, so that's one. The one I wanted to show this one, after the carpets are open, they are cleaned like this, manually. And what we provided is this one, a mechanism, 2 mechanisms together make a carpet cleaning machine of this type. Okay? Now this mechanism had a lot of vibrations. Okay? So once I stop here, so as I told you, 90% of the researchers are interested to solve for 10% of the rich people. But there's nobody to solve for this problem, right? I approached my faculty colleagues and students. Should we take this kind of projects? Not interested. Okay? They think, what kind of publication are we doing? Okay? So reason is, what is the research continent? Right? Because most of us, when we start researching, as a student also, what do you do these days? Google God is there in front of our laptop. Google God, tell me what is the research about industrial robots going on. No? 500 pages come and I just arbitrarily choose some, the identification is a nice idea. 10 papers come. And I look, what is the little hole is there in those 50 papers? There is a hole. They have used Gaussian elimination. Can I use Cholesky decompositions, right, for example? So I try Cholesky decomposition and I get some result and I publish a paper, right? So what is the research content? It is not known. Not fashionable either. You tell me, you ask me, sir, what kind of research? I'm doing research for carpet industry. Carpet industry. In Japan, we don't have any carpet. So, thank you, sir. Okay. You are not invited, okay, to Japan. But actually, if you go to the depth, actually, they're very difficult and limited literature. The difficulties I'll tell you immediately. Like the beam, which I showed you, right? If I tell you this is a beam of, say, drilling machines, you will get 100 literatures to tell you what should be the end condition of the beam. Whether it's a simply supported beam or it's a cantilever beam, right? Or bridge, civil engineering. But here, the beam will have what kind of support to even do the analysis is not known to me. So I have to put my brain into thinking more, what is the similarity it has, you know, the known structure, and try it out. And try it out several times, not once only. Okay? Okay. So, can I help? That is the answer I'll give you. Can I help? My areas of research is robotics, as I explained through my video. I'll show you one or two more slides about this, and multiple dynamics. Okay? When I talk about real application, when I think little deep, they are also machines, living machines, right? It could be robot also. In fact, I will show you that a professor in Italy has used this as a robotic leg. So, talking about my research, so this is the industrial robot, and I want to do the dynamic modeling of it. So, here I do the kinematic structure, and so my all knowledge is put it here in my robotics. This is the second edition of my book, and my first edition has been translated in Spanish. And it is used in China also, published by a Chinese publisher, taking the rights from the Indian publisher, to help students understand the robotics knowledge. Here is the robot as a software. I just demonstrate one analysis here. You can not only the dynamics, you can do kinematics also. For example, this KUKA robot you have seen here. Okay. So if I have to know about KUKA robot, so you click 6 degrees of freedom and select which are the robots available, KUKA robot, and you say okay. and cook robot will come in front of you. Once my niece, nephew, one of my nephews told me, after I demonstrated to my cousin, he asked me what kind of research you do, so I just demonstrated. Next time I go to his house, uncle, uncle, show me that video games. I said, oh, what video game? Then my cousin told me, oh, that's a robot you are showing some bug. So learn robotics through video games, right? That's my agenda now. Okay, so now I want you to see the DH parameter. Generally, it's a very confusing concept. Here I'm telling the meaning of DH parameter. So this variable, 0.18 means this distance. Okay? 90 degree means this angle. Okay? And 0.135 means this distance. So you can visualize DH parameters, not that only read from your book. So my message is learn the geometry and physics of robotics first. If you find robotics is difficult at the beginning, before you learn the mathematics of it. Okay, now inverse kinematics is a difficult concept. But here we made it simple. So here we have R. So we all know, for those who study robotics, that such kind of robot will have 8 solutions. Okay. So let's split I in and you get the 8 solutions. And then you want to see those solutions. So software show me the first one. So it has shown you the first solution, okay? If you wanted to see what is the end-effector configuration in terms of matrices, homogeneous transform matrix, this appears here, okay? Now you want to see the fourth solution maybe, the fourth solution, show the fourth solution, and it will show the fourth solution, okay? If you do not believe it or do not trust, you can go back to this, the homogeneous transform matrix, you will see exactly the same. You want to get a feel how it happens from one solution to another solution. You can come here and you can say, okay, go from solution 1 to solution 4, and then you show me some animation here, the forward kinematics, and then, okay. So it is moving from one solution to another solution. Okay. And then you can study dynamics, etc. We have about 16, 17 industrial robots also. And very recently, we have integrated with Peter Kors, a software called Robotics Toolbox in Queensland, because his graphics representation is not good. It's a MATLAB stick diagram, so we have integrated. And you can run from MATLAB, you can run from Excel sheets also. Well, the more detailed, and then it's multivariate dynamics, information is available here. In fact, both the books are lying here for you to view. And depending on which Professor Shivata likes, except this one, this is a very expensive one, I cannot afford to give you. But other one which Professor Shivata likes, I can give you for your views. This is the robotics one, and this is from PhD topic, by the way. So this is also available in this. It's a free, because my concept is make the knowledge available as much as possible without much cost. So here is the analysis using radiation recursive dynamic simulator, a gripper. Then a walking robot, a planar walking robot. For those who would like to use this thing, don't expect that tomorrow you will be able to use it successfully. You may have to use the reader's manual. But robot analyzer, almost instantly you can use it. But this is a little involved. Special walking, a control is included here, stable walking. Then here you have quadruped, four-legged and wheels, and then six-legged and wheels, okay? So as Professor Shibata told you, I'm approaching another 2-3 minutes. I think I'm going to finish it. This is a very interesting project. One of my colleagues wanted to solve a flexible system like a row using multi-dynamics approach. Here is one. Without going through finite element also, you can get fairly good results. This is that analysis of arthroscopic, this you have seen, so I'll stop it. But again, we did, this is multi-body dynamics, right? Because it's a mechanism, okay? So my student has analyzed it, and this is the torque requirement. And if you see this is the torque requirement by the motor, you can understand why the vibration is coming. It has a sudden high requirement of torque and suddenly high requirement on the reverse side. Obviously, vibration has happened. And then we wanted to compare the results with what the commercial software. This time it is an Adams. Adams is the industry standard almost for those car companies use the software. Okay? So it is compared. Okay? And then the thesis also converted to a monograph, and here we have given our mind here in the preface. The book has evolved from the passionate desire of the authors in using the modern concept of multi-body dynamics for the design improvement of the machineries used in the rural sectors of India and the world. In this connection, the first author took up the doctoral thesis and so on and so forth. So some feedback. One student, she has worked on the inverse kinematics module of my robot design. But after she got the job in Tata Motors, Tata Motors is one of the famous companies now for its Dano. Small car, cheap car, but good car. So after getting the job, she came to me. They asked, S is missing here. They say, though you are good in robotics, but we are not looking for the robotics expertise. I told I am working on some extra project under the same guy. These projects are mainly for the rural development. They asked me to draw the beam for the loom. And then they asked why that type of loading and the boundary condition. I answered. They said, good. After this, we discussed the joining. This is still one. So even though she was working in one of the most fashionable area, which is robotics, but the job she faced in the one of the best companies is because of her work experience. Yeah. So in conclusions, education and the role of teachers, I have fantastic. They knew the way I have now diverted my career. Robby as an innovative teaching methodology, I think this is innovative. Mudra also as an innovative research. Finally, an inclusive education was possible where fun, real life working in social and teaching also was involved. Because to have a full fledged teacher, engineer, I think we need to look into all aspects, not only one. So without these people, my family, our students' family, our staff family, we are nowhere, so we have acknowledgement. And this is for your information. I am thankful to Mr. Sibata who is coming to this conference with his students. How many students coming?
Coming one.
One, okay. We have another conference which is coming up in December, 16 to 19 December. The abstract deadline has gone, but the full paper deadline is still July 1st. I just got an email reply from the organizing secretary. I said, can you make a special case for my audiences in Japan? He said, please go ahead. No? So if you are truly interested to submit, the July 1st is the deadline, but for you, special July 15th, I took the permission. No? The full paper has to be submitted. Either mention my lecture or just to send to me, I'll forward to him. No? So, arigato gozaimasu.
First of all, thank you very much for your talk, very nice talk, branching from, not only from the viewpoint of research, but also education philosophy. And I apologize for our miscommunication.
No problem.
So this room is booked, fully booked.
Yeah.
You know, so until 6.
Let me share a joke with you.
4:40 p.m. But so announced, so it's open to the flyer. Yeah. So we go there for 1 hour. So
can I share a joke with you for 30 seconds? In India, when we do the puja means offerings to the gods and goddesses, right? Not everybody can do it. A special class of people can do it, right? So when they come and sit down in front of the gods and goddesses, the first thing they will see, they will walk in front of them. What are the offerings are made to the gods and goddesses, which ultimately come to his home, right? So depending on how much or how the quantity, the offerings can be 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 30 minutes, 1 hour, 2 hours. So we teachers have a similar tendency, right? Depending on how much time is given to us, I think we can change our time of So as soon as he said, I have to internally change. Thank you.
So actually, so British students, I think they felt.
Yeah.
So after passing some secret paper to him, so his speaking speed will get much faster.
そう、4時10分が撮ってあったんですね。で、フライヤーっていうかそのチラシには1時間ってことにしてました。なんで、先生ですね、今日途中で数式すごい飛ばしたりとかしてくださってたので、多分顧問だと思ったんですね。なんかもっと捕まえていろいろお話ししたいという人はぜひこの後。
So because still we have time.
Okay.
So maybe somebody, some yes. students are really interested in your questions today.
Right.
So can catch you for me?
Yes,
for
yes. I have some few flyers of these two concepts, so if you think you would like to pick up one, pick up. If you don't get one, send me an email, I'll send you some.
Thank you for professor. I have a question in the technical side
right.
and the general education side. So now I am focusing on the parallel mechanism. And so the professor mentioned that the singularity is the one of the difficult tasks to solve.
Yes.
So so now the professor mentioned the gain technique is very important. So on the other hand, there is the kinematical side. So the structure is something like the idea in the kinematic space, the measurement or something. I knew the manipulability or something, but the parallel mechanism is really tough to get some the measurement from. That is the one point. And also the second point is so your message, the design for the other 90 is a very tough issue. So now I heard that, so I am very confusing. So sometimes we can guess the someone's the needs, but sometimes very tough to understand that the others the thinking or mind. So how can we manage that?
Well, the first one, you can measure the singularity using the condition number of the Jacobian. The famous Professor Yoshikawa sensei also said about manipulability of those things. So you can use those measures to find out the singularity. And you can also design the architecture in such a manner that you don't have any singularity in the zone of working you are interested. Okay? So there is a professor in IIT, in India, the IIT Madras. He has developed a bicycle simulator by doing this analysis of singularity free manipulation. For the second part, the best way to know other people is to make friends with them. Okay? And in Japan, because of its economic good conditions, you may not find them in large numbers. Right? But to meet them, you have to come to us. I will take you to those places and you can make friends. And once you start talking to them, mixing with them, you can understand. But it's a very difficult task, very difficult. Because your thinking, my thinking, living in cities, would be very different than them. Just to give an example, this loom we have designed. So they tried to operate the loom, the gearbox, which they could not do it. So what they did is they stood on it and started jumping on it. Because they thought the one wheel, they are not able to tighten it. So they said if they jump on it, they will tighten it, right? But actually it broke because the jumping created an impact load. Okay? And they commented to us, the material of the gear is bad, which is not true. The design was wrong. The size of the gear cannot generate the tension. So when you observe going there, and then redesign it, then it will fine. So this kind of confusing messages can come, which may divert you in the wrong direction. So understanding their statement and their way of using it is also very important. In fact, there's a Japanese book from the Sony, Akio Morita, is no more. You should read Made in Japan. There's a book called Made in Japan. And it talks about how Sony's product was misused by the people, and then Sony Center concept has come. So all customers are explained what's Sony's features if you go to the Sony segment. So this is the same thing for this kind of products as well.
Okay, so any other comments or questions? One or two?
Yeah, please.
You are also interested in making some robotics for the environmental things, for some paralyzed
humans.
And suppose some, there may be some accident.
Yes.
There was some cutbread.
Yes.
And so you can use making some devices.
Sure.
That will be from the encephalitum of brain that will be doing some of the.
Yes.
Okay,
I understand. This is also a very important area, and also it will help the poor people. Also, I am not taking up this kind of research myself, but in my group, there are many professors. We have Center for Biomedical Engineering also. In our mechanical engineering department, there are two or three professors who are very much interested. I have helped one of the professors to design the artificial knee for the leg amputees. So it was made from some polycarbonate material. So those cutting, testing, and design aspects I have. But with people, I am not interested because I think now I am old, not to gain, but slowly try to return. So whatever I learned, let me compile and return to the society. So multi-body dynamics is my core and robotics is my core. I said, let me make bigger and bigger knowledge in that and try to share with young people. Yeah, please.
So you said that we should consider about the other 90% also. So considering the 90% is very huge and we have limited reach, outreach, so even we consider developing some projects, we can only interact with 1-to-1 or 1-to-1 village. So how can we impact the 90%? It will still be 1% or 0.1%.
Very good. Very good question. If you read the Design for Other 90% book, the first story comes out from a Stanford PhD holder. After PhD, he thought what to do, take a job in a company or teach in a university. So he thought take a 1 month break to go to South America. He traveled to Peru, and when he saw the conditions in Peru, so he decided as an engineer he must contribute to the society. Okay. So last, I bought this book 2012. So 20 years he's living there, you know, working for this community. And as I told you in my presentation, the whole world is also trying to do something for several reasons. One reason is sympathy, fellow feelings. The another reason is economic reasons, right? Because today a big company, if they manufacture products, who will buy the products? After some time, even the developed countries will saturate with their products. They have to be sold somewhere. Somebody has to use it. Okay? So unless you increase the income level of those people, they will not be able to buy it. So Stanford has a program, Purdue has a program, at least 18 universities have a very strong program. Okay? And as is the other one. Okay? And in that process, you are, as an engineer, you are gaining first-hand knowledge of how to create products, and which are not so expensive. So one of my students, I asked, why do you come to me for such work? He said, sir, if I study robotics, I cannot build a robot because it's so expensive. But if I make this kind of machine, I can make it, and before I graduate, I can see whether it's working or not. So let me start from somewhere. And like me, I have started propagating. You know? So today, I have about 30, 40 students who have at least heard. Do you follow or not? I do not know. Maybe some of you. That's possible.
Okay, thank you.
Final one. Actually, I want to ask two questions, again, for one from the practical side and one from that we talked already, 90%, how to reach to the 90%. So the first question is like you saw the walking mechanism of quadruped robot, humanoid robot. So is it all dependent upon the mechanical design equations, or we are involved in some brain-inspired mechanism also for that? That is the one question. And the second part is like, when we say that we want to reach to the 90%, we should look at the economic chain also. And the economic chain is a very confined loop, that money comes from 10% and we produce for 10%. But when it comes to produce for the 90%, obviously it's not too much money required, but the amount of money that is required, how to break that loop of the chain of economic cycle and then push the money back to the 90% people to create for them? That is the question.
Thank you. Second one is tough question. The first one, in our, since I'm the multi-dynamics person, for our modeling, it is a purely dynamic modeling, no brain. We assume that some actuation will happen by the actuators, but that the signal comes from the brain, we do not know. Okay? So we have to see if this is my initial position, and if I do this kind of walking, whether I fall or not. If I fall, what could be the PID gains? To not to let fall based on ZMP. The second question requires the involvement of the economists as well in this loop. We are the technical people. We can design things. Okay? But whether it is creating the impact, the right impact, the wrong impact, you know? So all those analyses have to be done by the economists and the social scientists. Just to give you an example. Recently, we have introduced a small motor in order to make beads from the tulsi system. Tulsi is the holy basil. It's very good for the health, which are used in the temples in large number. After making this device, when we took the feedback, we saw that the motors which we proposed, they are not using. After it goes bad, they get a local motor, and which burns very frequently, and it has caused almost an accident. Okay? So after this, I was a little worried. So I have involved one of the social scientists, professor in our humanities department. I have requested her, can she help me in the studies, that whether my improvement has really made a social impact, positive or negative. No? So now we are trying to bring that kind of expertise also to do. In fact, all programs, whether it's a nuclear or America, they're also involving their social scientists as well as economists with the engineers to make a complete picture of the contributors. It's difficult, yes. Thank you.
Okay, I think it's a bit better to close this session and maybe some students, specifically personally, what would like to contact.
My email address is there, you saw it. So I'll write it again here before you go. You can, very easy. Saha, IITD, REST, Gmail.
Yeah, actually, so I googled your name and it shows you, I mean, your homepage, first page.
There is.
So let's Google SK Saha. SK Saha, and you'll see his very fancy, very nice homepage.
Remember my homepage. Hiragana, katakana, to impress you.
Okay, so we'll give the professor to the professor your big hand. Thank you very much.
Thank you. So, as a proof in front of you, right? Which one? Not which one you like your professor to take? So, proof, I'm giving it to him.
Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
なんかあのロボコンとかね、あのロボットのエデュケーションとかの話で、ターンボーの話は説明一応しておきますけど、なんか今後、あの和田先生がそもそも学生さんにいられるって言ったりとかね、あの留学経験をさせたりとか、どうぞどうぞとかいう話されてたんで、まあ、今後のその留学先としてもですね、とてもいいじゃないかと。あの IIT デリーは非常に、まあ、僕いろんなの IIT 行ってるんですけど、IIT デリーが一番行きやすい。正直デリー空港を見てもうあと車で20分ぐらいか、混んでなければ20分ぐらいで到着して、さっきみたいな綺麗なキャンパスなんですね。非常にいいですね。ジョードプールもまあまあ行きやすい。
半分とデリーになってます。
でだからターンロボティクスの、ね、講師とかあるんで、
はい、そ
のある場所に
行く
と、
CLT
ですね。で、小田澄先生がね、カードを持たれてました。はい、じゃあ頑張りましょう。
Thank you.